year, John Bergfan sponsors an organization that gives back to community. This year is Easter Seals. Fortunately, we have two members, one in the back and a representative from the organization, to come and talk to you about the organization. Without further ado, Matthew Willard.
Receive services from this wonderful organization and wanted to share part of my story. I was born 12 weeks too early, weighing 2 pounds. I must have been very eager to meet my parents because I just couldn't wait anymore. I gave the doctors and nurses a run for their money each day in the NICU. The alarms are always beeping and buzzing because I kept kicking the pulse ox off my foot. The nurses would sit and answer my parents' questions each shift. They had a lot. As days turned to months, I was finally discharged from the NICU to this new place called home. My parents prepared. They moved all my equipment into my new room. A nurse came to visit, then another. My mom had asked so many questions in the NICU that she had early intervention services lined up the day of discharge. After my discharge, I started with physical, occupational, speech, developmental, and vision therapy. It was a busy time. Life with me was doctor's appointments, therapy, and sleep. As months were flying by, I was still dependent on oxygen. Wherever I went, my parents would carry a 25-pound oxygen tank, too. This is one thing I could not shake till 9 months later. During my time in early intervention, my parents took me to a follow-up doctor's appointment where they learned I had cerebral palsy and would not have full function of my left side. My parents worked hard with therapists and doctors to get therapy increased. Working hard, the PT mentioned to my parents they may want to think about school when I turn 3 and needing a wheelchair because I may never walk. This news hit my parents' heart. My mom one day opened the paper and was reading about Easter Seals, and she thought, that's where we're going to go. Shortly after that, I started Easter Seals in Villa Park, and my life changed forever. Speech was the first discipline I began, working on breath support since I was oxygen dependent so long. The goal was to blow candles out of my birthday cake. Soon after this, my parents decided to sell our home in Bartlett for a more suitable home in Schaumburg. With dedicated parents and a hard-working team of therapists, I took my old sweet time on increasing strength, stamina, and mindset, that one day I took my first steps. Proud parents made not the call to the grandparents, but to the PT. He's walking. He's walking. After early childhood at age 3, my parents moved all my services to Easter Seals. Why not the best work there? Hundreds, maybe thousands of hours of work in therapy and at home, working on breath support, speech and small and large muscles, working hard sometimes, having bad days. I could never give up. Later, my parents were told about Easter Seals community-based therapy programs. I have taken many community-based programs through Easter Seals that have had to offer over the years. I'm glad I did. I would not have been where I am today. But all the dedication the staff gives, especially when the first 5 count. My parents tell the story of me taking a feeding grant class. I took the class 2 times. The goal was getting different foods into me, like pasta, meat, vegetables, and even lobster. Class about getting messy and liking it? No, thank you. We'll just say I passed the class. All in all, I learned it was fun to play with finger paint, shaving cream, and glue. Rock climbing, this was the best. I took this for OT and finger strength first, and then PT for leg strength. I was scared during my first climbs, but the classmates rallied for me down the ground until I reached the last 5 rocks to ring the bell. I made it. What a feeling. Next class, I was ready. I knew I could do it. My parents have always encouraged me, go out there and do it. They remind me of your determination. I have even had a chance to ditch those extra rules on the bike. Boy, was I scared. I was the only client that paid by volunteers to run with me the entire time with any breaks. I really wanted to finish with 2 wheels. By the last day, I was almost there. It was just hard to believe. Many staff and colleagues I'm here today were always there cheering me on until I reached success. The therapists are angels in our family. Easter Seals staff, was the extended family that understood the new normal we were living. The support that we shared with me and my family was priceless. Learning about support services outside of Easter Seals, recommendations of doctors, meeting other parents with similar challenges. Easter Seals is family. To this day, I give back by volunteering often. Easter Seals has helped me so much, especially with my independence and determination 15 years later. Thank you. It is now with great pleasure that I introduce Director of Development and Marketing for Easter Seals, Paige in the Fox Valley, Kelly Morgan.
For entertaining us tonight and for selecting Easter Seals DuPage and Fox Valley as the beneficiary of this week's concerts. I want to congratulate Matthew on how hard he's worked and how far he's come. I have the unique privilege to witness infants and children with developmental delays and disabilities achieve life-changing milestones every day. And I'm so proud to be a part of the work that we do to provide therapy services and support to these children and their families who need them to live their best life. So Matthew's a wonderful example of what can be accomplished at Easter Seals, and I just wanted to take a couple minutes to show you a short video about us and the journey of a young girl named Brinley.
They did an MRI when she was, I think, 2 days old and determined that her brain didn't form fully and correctly in utero. And so, you know, we didn't know what to do with that information. We said, will she walk? And they said, we don't know. And I said, will she talk? And they're like, we don't know.
When I first met Brinley, it was in follow-up clinic. And she had, at that time, I believe, 6 medical complications in her diagnosis. And her progress has been amazing. And she's a hard worker.
For Brinley, we celebrate everything. We celebrate every single milestone she makes. Things that weren't even milestones for the other kids are huge for Brinley and for us. The Run for the Kids is a 5K that Mr. Seals does each year. First year we only had about 6 people that walked with us, just some real close friends. And then the following year, we had a team of about 50 and really walked across the finish line herself. It was unbelievable. And her team was on the side and her parents were there. And it was perfect. It was perfect.
The fact that this little girl has so many challenges and she's listen to the occasion is amazing. But that's what's amazing about Easter Seals. We get to see that every day. We have lots of people with lots of experience and lots of strong certifications and backgrounds. But I will tell you, the greatest thing we have going here is the other families. I mean, and that's really what it's all about. I mean, you want to know who was there, who had a kid like mine.
Good evening, everyone. Thank you again for coming out to tonight's concert, for supporting the Easter Seals organization, and for supporting our students here on stage. As Brandon mentioned, we have a guest conductor with us tonight. You can read more about him in your program, but he has actually been out to work with the bands 3 separate times over the course of the last couple weeks, and he's just been a thrill to watch him work with the students and see the passion that he brings every day to the podium. She is the former director of bands from Wheeling High School, currently associate professor at Vanderbilt College of Music. Please welcome Mr. Brian Logan.
Traveled to the Cumberland Mountains and transcribed words and melodies for over 200 songs. This collection showcased how the Kentucky Mountaineers helped to propagate and proud heritage other traditional ballets and other old Scottish and English folk songs that had been brought to America by their ancestors. As customary multi-movement works, please hold your applause until the end of the song, until the end of the second movement. We hope you enjoy the song titled Kentucky by Brian Carrick. Thank you.
Thank you.
The painting showed a small child and a grandfather facing away. The whole painting was in black and white, with the only color on the canvas being a red balloon held by the child. The music depicts the balloon's journey floating in the air. Please enjoy Annie McGrady's The Red Balloon.
Thank you. is Crystal Maharis, and I play alto saxophone. Crown of Castile by John and Vincent is a Spanish march that depicts the Kingdom of Castile, once one of the medieval kingdoms of the Iberian Peninsula, which is located in the extreme southwest of Europe and includes modern-day Spain, Portugal, Andorra, Gibraltar, and a small area of France. It was one of the kingdoms that founded the Crown of Castile, which was considered to have begun in the year 1230 with the union of the monarchies of the kingdoms of Castile and Toledo and the kingdoms of Leon and Galicia. The march employs elements in the melody and harmony that evoke the images of this fascinating time in Spanish history. We hope you enjoy the Crown of Castile.
Sovereign Variance by James Corneau was commissioned by and dedicated to the students of the King City Secondary School in Ontario, Canada. After a brilliant opening fanfare, the main theme is woven through variations in three large contrasting sections, with the fanfare returning to culminate this work, which has become a staple in wind band literature. Thank you for coming out to tonight's concert and supporting the Easter Seals. Please welcome back to the stage Mr. Brian Logan to close our concert with Sovereign Variants.
I could say a few words here tonight. This is my third time out here, and I want you to know that what you have here is special. This is about the 80th school I've been to so far this year, guest conducting. And you remember the schools that are really great. You remember the schools that aren't so great, and there's a whole lot in the middle. And what you have here is really great. It's not just the music making that's great. As a matter of fact, the music making is secondary what makes this program so special. Your directors are as good as it gets because they don't just care about the music. As a matter of fact, once again, it's secondary. They care about the students as people first. And what they demonstrate, what I see from these kids every day, is their level of character. And the things that they're doing every day, because their directors, they believe what they want from fine people, good citizens. When they enter the band room every day, watching the directors stand by the door, big smile, shaking hands, pat them back, and there's such an attitude of joyful music making that because they're great citizens and terrific people, the students can't help but be that. Now, so not just if they could, just thank these directors, they're amazing. Successful program is having just terrific musicians and teachers who get the big picture. But the second thing that's got to happen is you got to have students that are committed to it and making sure they're doing the work. And clearly they have that as well. So the next people I think we need to applaud again is these two wonderful bands. Bravo. And finally, but certainly not in any particular order, I don't want the parents to feel bad about just being third on this list. But really, with the lessons and the instruments, and you notice like when those kids start playing those instruments and squeaking and squawking, and you had to look at them and say, "That sounds great, Jimmy," and you lied a little bit, but that's okay, it's a good lie. And because now look what happens, they go ahead and get to this level, and they're doing great things, and tomorrow night there's another concert here. And then back to my first point, about just not about music, but about character, with what Matthew talked about tonight and what tonight's concert is all about. It just kind of brings it all together. And when you have teachers that are working with kids who have a wonderful example at home about what this is all supposed to be about, music making can't help but happen in a really positive setting like we have here. So it's such a privilege and an honor to be invited to come on out here, and we'll be here again tomorrow night. So bring your checkbooks, write big checks to Easter Seals. What a wonderful opportunity for you to do that. And come and hear some incredible music tomorrow night. Thank you very much. Here is our Sovereign Variants.
everyone for coming this evening. As you walk out, we will have our representatives from the Easter Seals here. They have a table just outside the auditorium foyer. We invite you to learn more about their amazing programs that they have there. And if you feel so inclined, you're certainly welcome to donate to that as well. And then as a reminder, we do have our concerts tomorrow for the Symphonic Band and the Wind Symphony, so we hope to see you then as well. Thanks again to our students for an incredible performance this evening, and thanks again to Brian Logan for all his work with the kids over the last couple of weeks. Thank you.